Today's Midday Kentucky Cooking Segment brought to you by Creative Kitchen and Bath, where you will always cook in style.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Midday Kentucky, over here with Allison Davis at Creative Kitchen and Bath for all your renovation needs.
Well, that was...
Do you like that?
Yeah, that was just perfect.
Smooth.
Yes.
Insert commercial.
Just like Creative Kitchen.
Okay, darling.
All right.
What are we doing?
So, it's summertime, and I'm always looking for just like simple recipes that are fresh, clean, also that you can make ahead of time, you know, because I don't want to be a slave to the kitchen in the summer any more than anyone else does.
Yeah.
So this is a green bean kind of slaw salad that you can actually whip up and even keep overnight and then serve like
beans.
The next day. I actually prefer
like
the hair covets, you know, if you can find them, which are the thin, more
yeah, me
French
too.
Green beans.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I like those, but if not, you can use just a standard green bean.
Whole Foods and Trader Joe's always have those.
Always have them in stock,
yeah.
That's true.
Because I normally buy them by the bag and just eat them at night.
Yeah, because they're perfect crispness.
Love
and
them.
Yeah.
And they've got a little sweetness to
so
them.
So the fact that I'm using these larger, just kind of traditional green beans, I'm definitely going
they're
to blanch them.
They were on special at the supermarket?
They were indeed. We're going to blanch them just in a little bit of salted water, which means just drop them into hot, like boiling water for honestly no more than 30 seconds. And you can just see like where it almost gets a brighter green color,
yeah.
You know, from doing that.
Do you put bicarb soda in there?
No, just salt.
Okay.
Yeah. So then I am going to just strain this off and then we're going to saute off a few vegetables.
Okay.
And then we'll add this to it.
Oh.
And then it just gets tossed together in basically like a nice vinaigrette, which I'll go over.
That so doesn't seem like it's on.
We've got a little bit of olive oil in the pan here. We're heating it up. I'm going to drain our beans and then we're going to start with a little bit of saute of red onion. And then I have some julienne stripped of some red bell pepper and then parsnip.
Red bell pepper.
Are you familiar with parsnips? Yeah.
Parsnip soup?
Yeah, we've had that before, I think. But parsnip is more of a root vegetable, but it's certainly going to bring a nice earthy, kind of almost like anise, like just a rich flavor to this slaw.
I thought I liked those peppers.
Red bell peppers?
Yeah, but not so much on just like one piece. Or maybe I like it in
mixed
things.
Mixed in, right. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's what we're going to do.
This is getting hot
yeah,
now.
Yeah, so we're hot. We're good to go. So we're going to start with a little bit of red onion.
Mm.
You can go ahead
Let me get the thing for you.
Oh, I've got it right here, babe.
Oh, good.
So you can add in some red bell pepper. I'll turn our heat
Oh, already?
Uh-huh. For some reason, it turned down on us.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got red bell pepper. Now, the recipe you're going to get calls for julienne carrot strips, but one of your great cheats in the grocery store, you can find just the shredded carrots.
Who buys them any other way?
Right, so this is just an easy like cheat. Instead of you having to take a carrot, cut it, and cut it into julienne strips.
No, thank you.
Go ahead and just buy the shredded, throw it
you
in
You know
there.
What I'm into right now? The shredded chicken at the deli.
Okay.
You go to the rotisserie section.
Yeah.
And they
it is
have
just
the shredded
the
chicken.
Rotisserie chicken. Yeah, Fresh Market.
Why would I do it any other way?
Fresh Market has a great rotisserie chicken salad.
Yeah.
They just take all their rotisserie bits.
Yeah, I think it's from the morning because I go in the afternoons.
Perfect.
And I said to the lady the other day at the store at Maya, I was on the way home from the station, and I said, oh, honey, you've run out of chicken. She said, not for you. I'll go get a couple. Fresh chicken in the black bag. I loved it. What are you doing?
Perfect. So we're adding our parsnips in. Parsnips actually are, like I said, more of a root vegetable, so we really want to saute them a little bit.
Oh.
This is a quick saute just to soften up our vegetables together.
What are you putting?
A little bit of salt and pepper. And then we're going to toss all this together. I'm going to add our green beans into this. And then I'm going to make a vinaigrette. And then this, again, could be served up the day after. Look at the colors, though. Isn't it gorgeous? He's getting nervous. I'm filling his pan up.
I'm thinking, what is she doing here?
No, I mean, you've got such bright colors. To me, it just screams summer because it's just fresh vegetables. We're not overcooking them. We want them to still be a little bit of crisp. All right, a little bit of garlic.
Can I ask you something?
Uh-huh.
Why didn't you put the garlic in first and saute
it? Garlic will burn.
Oh.
So I added a little bit later because I don't want the garlic to start burning and getting too crisp. So I actually usually will add the garlic towards the end.
Oh.
So, but good question. All right, so my vinaigrette that's going to be tossed in with all of our salad ingredients, I've got some Dijon mustard. I'm going in with a little bit of honey.
Hey, hon.
Uh-huh.
We've run out of time.
Apple cider vinegar, a little Worcestershire sauce, a little hot sauce, and throw it all together.
The recipe.
Let it sit overnight. It's fantastic.
All right, we're going to give you the recipe after we tell you where to go and get the recipe, wtvq.com/recipes on the recipe tab. Allison Davis' Instagram account is?
WildThymeCooking.com.
That's it.
And yeah.
Back after this short break, everyone.
Today's cooking segment was brought to you by Creative Kitchen and Bath, where you will always cook in style.